ಸರಿಸು ಎನ್ನ ಸಂಸ್ಕರಿಸು ಬರಿದಾದ ಬಾಳನ್ನು ನೀಹರಸು ಎನ್ನ
ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಸು. The first Jesuit who came to India, as we all know, is Franz Xaver. After him in India, Robert de Nobili, it is to Madurai, and here Chinnami. And after Chinnami came Antony Maria Plate, who is called locally as Rajendra Swami. While the Jesuits in southern India, that is in Madurai, they call that either Madurai Mission or Malabar Mission. This is called Canara Mission. Not exactly Canada Mission, but Canara Mission, which involves a vast area of the present Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Andhra. So way back in 1701, Antony Maria Plate came to India, to Goa. He was actually a professor of grammar. He desired to become a missionary. He heard about the life of John de Brito, who is called Alvananda in Tamil Nadu. And being motivated by him, he came over here. He met the king or Maharaja of Srinagapatna, the Immadi Krishnaraja Vadiyar, who asked him to go to this place called Chikkarasingare and gave this place for his mission. He built a altar here to Mother Mary, that is Our Lady of Rosary, and from here he went all round. From here his mission extended all over southern Karnataka. He picked up three languages very fast: Kannada, Tamil and Telugu. There are people of three languages even now also in this area, and therefore he was able to interact with them, and for their benefit he had a small catechism book called Jnanamuthumala in all three languages. Unfortunately we lost it, but the tradition, people know that he is the one who taught them the prayers. He was a great devotee of Mother Mary, and he lived here from 1704 to 1719. His desire was to come and offer the last mass. He was ill for a long time in Srinagapatna, and they carried him. He came here on 7th of October 1719. On that he came and said his last mass, being the day of Our Lady of Rosary, and on the following day he breathed his last. And what happened later? That particular year when he died, there was no rain, and people were disturbed, the neighboring villagers. They thought, because he is an outsider, a white skinned man, they thought because of him a curse has come and God has not given rain. So they want to remove the body and exhume him, but the Christians prayed not to do it. When they were insisting, the Christians came and prayed, raising their hands to heaven, and surprisingly there was a downpour. That's the first miracle. The year 2017, the Bishop of Mysore declared it as a shrine, and 2019 the Pope allowed him to be called servant of God. Hence on 1st of May there was a grand celebration, and Rajendra Swami has been declared servant of God.
Ellavu ninnade
nilajalavu gidamaravu ellavu ninnade.
In my experience, my daughter, she was a premature child and had lots of complications with regard to her stomach. She couldn't eat anything and nothing would digest, and it was visit here and a little bit of that mud on the grave of Swami Rajendra that we put into her mouth, and later it was a big miracle. It was like instant. You didn't have to wait for many days. We saw a great change, that she could eat everything, and till today we have no problems. And also recently my mother was affected with COVID, and because she's old, she's 65 plus, so she was diagnosed COVID, and she didn't know what to do. She visited this place, and again the little bit of mud in her mouth has completely cured her.
Amma anna ನಮ್ಮ ಅಣ್ಣವರು ಅವರು ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರ್ 8ಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂದರೆ 2-3 ವರ್ಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಹಬ್ಬಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಿದ್ರು. ಆವಾಗ ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮೊದಲು ಅವರಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ದೂರ ಹೋಗೋಕ್ಕಾಗ್ತಾ ಇರಲ್ಲ, ನಡೀಕ್ಕಾಗ್ತಾ ಇರಲ್ಲ, ಒಬ್ಬರು ಹಿಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಿತ್ತು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹಬ್ಬಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ರು. ಹಬ್ಬಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಹಬ್ಬ ಮುಗಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆ ದಿನ ಸಾಯಂಕಾಲ ಅವರು ಮೈಸೂರಿಗೆ ಹೋದರು. ಮೈಸೂರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುವಾಗ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ. ಹೋದಾಗ ಅವರು ರಾತ್ರಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನೈಟಲ್ಲಿ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೋವು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿಬಿಡ್ತು. ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೋವು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಬಂದು ಏನು ಮಾಡೋದಂತ ಇದಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟ್ರ್ ಹತ್ರ ನಾವು ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಇದು ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಅವರು ಒಳಗಡೆಗೆ ಇದಾಗಿದೆ, ಯಾವುದು ಅಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇದಾಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಫುಲ್ಲು ಇದಾಗಿ ಇದಾಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ. ಏನು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ. ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮೊದಲೂ ಫೀಡ್ಸ್ ಇತ್ತು, ಅದರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗೋಗದೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಈ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ನು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ರಜ್ಞೆ ತಪ್ಪಿದ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಪುನಃ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರಲ್ಲ, ಹಂಗೆ ಆಗೋಗಿತ್ತು. ಆದರೂ ಡಾಕ್ಟ್ರು ನಾವು ಏನು ಹೇಳೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಏನು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಧೈರ್ಯದಿಂದ ನಾವೇ ಇದು ಮಾಡಿ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಆವಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಡಾಕ್ಟ್ರುಗಳು ಸೇರಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಿ ಇದು ಮಾಡಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಅವರು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಇದಕ್ಕೂ ಊರಿಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೂ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಯಾವ ಇದರಲ್ಲೂ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಯಾರೊಬ್ಬರು ಬೇಕಿಲ್ಲ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಸಹಾಯಕ್ಕೆ.
I'm Sister Lumina, SAB Congregation, St. Anne's of Bangalore. My sister-in-law was very sick. She was admitted in St. John's Hospital. She had pneumonia attack. And she was hospitalized for 45 days. She was in coma. I prayed to Rajendra Swami and she miraculously, she got regained the conscience and she is well now. ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಟು ರಾಜೇಂದ್ರ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ.
ನನ್ನ ಅನುಭವ ಏನಂದರೆ, ಈ ಸ್ಥಳ 2000 ವರ್ಷಗಳ ಹಿಂದೆ ಯೇಸು ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅದ್ಭುತಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಲ್ವ, ಆ ಅದ್ಭುತಗಳನ್ನು ಈ ಸ್ಥಳದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ.
ಮೂರು ವರ್ಷ ಕೆಳಗಿಂದ ಬರ್ತಾಯಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಚಕಣೆ ಇದಾಗಿತ್ತು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೋ ಕೆರೆದ ಮೇಲೆ ಕಕ್ಕಿಸ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಯ್ತು. ಈಗ
ಅದು ಏನು
ಸೈಕಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಸೈಕಲ್ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ.
ರಸದ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಅರ್ಪಿಪೆಯನ್ನೆ ನಿನಗೆ
ಇನ್ನ ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಸು, ಇನ್ನ ಸಂಸ್ಕರಿಸು, ಬರಿದಾದ ಬಾಳನ್ನು ನೀರಸು.
ಇನ್ನ ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಸು, ಇನ್ನ ಸಂಸ್ಕರಿಸು, ಬರಿದಾದ ಬಾಳನ್ನು ನೀರಸು. ಜಲವು ಗಿಡ ಮರವು ಎಲ್ಲವೂ ನಿನ್ನದೇ.